Okay, my fellow YouTube friends, today we're going to show you one mistake most Nest thermostat owners make. So to show this to you, we're going to take the Nest off the wall and show you what's going on. Okay, we got the Nest thermostat off the wall, and what you can see is the back plate here. But if you notice very closely, there is a gaping hole in there from where the wires come feeding. If they're fed from the attic coming this way, or if they're fed from the bottom, if your house has a crawl space, it's coming this way. So basically what's going on here is your wall cavity is hollow. And if you look at a picture that I'm going to provide very soon, you'll see that the wall cavities have wires, both for electrical or for your thermostat in this case, as well as plumbing that's running through the top plate, being the plate that's connected up here, or the bottom plate connected from the bottom. Okay, so what we're gonna do is we're gonna take this great stuff, spray foam insulation, and what we're gonna do is seal that opening there. The reason why is that hole is connected to your actual hollow wall cavity. And if you live in a cold climate where you're heating most of the year in the winter time, winter months, and you have a crawl space underneath the home, that cold air is coming towards your hollow wall cavity through that orifice and into the back of your thermostat. And your thermostat is picking that up as ambient temperature. And you don't want it to do that. If you're in an area where you're most of your days in the year are hot, then that heat coming from your attic space, which is over 110 degrees sometimes, can be coming through this opening, through this orifice, and making the thermostat think that it's really hot in the house when in reality it might not. So we're going to see how we fix this with this foam. Okay, so one thing you're going to want to do is, if you have cotton balls or just regular tissue paper or even newspaper, is try to fill it in as much as you can, just so the spray foam, when you spray it in there, will be held, so to speak, by the paper that you've put in there, just to give it some consistency. And then what you want to do is put some clear tape, like so. And what I'll do is I'll poke a little hole here with a pen or a pencil, just enough so I can fit the straw of the great stuff spray insulation. So once you do that, you'll prevent the foam from overspraying and, you know, making a mess around here. So just big enough so that this little straw will fit in there. So as you can see, it doesn't have to be a big hole, just a little slit if you want, or making the hole with a pen or a pencil will take care of that. So we're going to do that now and start spraying. Okay, so our straw's in there. We're going to start spraying. Here we go. We're basically filling up that wall cavity with spray foam just to insulate the thermostat from any hot or cold air hitting the back of it. So we're going to empty the can and tune back into the video. Okay, so once the spray foam is cured, you can remove the tape, or at least semi-cured, where it's not going to expand anymore. You can just remove the tape. And once you're done with removing the tape, you may go ahead and put the thermostat back in there. So what's going to happen now is this will stop any unconditioned air, whether it's hot or cold, from coming into the back of that thermostat. Okay. And the thermostat will not pick it up as conditioned air. So we'll put the thermostat back in and give some final thoughts. Okay, fellow YouTubers, so now that the thermostat's back on the wall, just some final thoughts here. The reason, or the one mistake most Nest owners make, is that they install the Nest thermostat and they completely have no idea of that hole in the back that we showed you earlier. So sealing that hole and insulating it will give you adequate temperature readings in the house and you'll be comfortable year round. Thank you for watching. Have a nice, wonderful day. I'm not one.